good Sunday evening. Thank you, Lee, for grace you in this morning. Thank you for the choir this morning. We can't get a choir up here. Everybody just follow your heart tonight. That's what I say if I'm standing for each other. Everybody just follow your heart. Sing from the heart. You feel shout, shout. You feel the room. Whatever you feel, do. Just do it.
That's been 336.
Yeah, you know. 336. What's in it?
Yep.
336. Yeah. Or keep the rest. 336.
And
Everybody stand. Thank you, thanks for staying.
Thank you.
Something. I know there's a lot of people that here has got needs. Every one of us got needs, if we'll be honest. We've all got unspoken. But that's part of it. And you know, a lot of people don't want to request your unspoken. That's okay. The Lord knows everything. He knows all about it. And it don't make no difference if the preacher knows it or if the church members know it. You make your request known unto the Lord. And I want everybody, for me and Jake are going to sing here in just a minute, but I know this is ordinary, but I'm just going to follow the heart. Just want everybody that's got a need or whatever just come up, and I want us to pray for the service and pray for the Word of God, and I'll preach just what He gave me. And I know that's unordinary, but something will come out. Just want everybody to gather around here.
I
want to
praise the Lord to say to my son all the blessings. Amen. I want to live close and close and share me today.
Amen. Remember Mama tomorrow night. She goes to the lung doctor.
Yeah. Remember Jim too.
Amen. Remember our mom too. Amen. So much to pray for.
Lord, I thank you, Lord, for the mother of God. Thank you, Lord.
be here tonight. And thank you. Be at Grace Union has been out to spread the word. It's hard sometimes to pray two times in one day. That's the calling of the Lord Christ upon my life. So I go by what the scripture says, be instant in season and out of season. And I think about a lot of preachers, they used to preach twice in a day, but some preachers are just used to preaching once, and that's me. I'm just used to preaching one time. But that's all right. I'm expecting, as I say often, I say just about everywhere I go, I come expecting the Lord to pass by and come praying. And I hope that you did too, and I say it pretty plain, but if you didn't come expecting that, you're just better off just staying home.
Right.
That'd have been the same way with me if I didn't come. I wonder many times what people would do if a preacher didn't come with anything. A lot of people expect the preachers to have a word, but we're supposed to. If you got your Bibles this morning, or tonight rather, I want you to turn to Romans chapter 12. I'm going to start in verse 1. There, say amen.
Amen.
I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly according as God hath dealt to every man the measure of faith. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office, so we, being many, are one body in Christ, and every one members one of another. I want to read verse 2 one more time. Y'all pay attention to them words. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Heavenly Father, Lord, I bow unto you another time, Lord, tonight. Thankful, Lord, for the word that you put upon my heart to preach. And Lord, I pray that you would anoint these humble lips of clay one more time as I stand to preach your word. And Lord, I pray, Lord, that people will have their hearts open to receive the word that you gave me. And Lord, if anybody be here tonight, Lord, that's lost and undone, Lord, I pray that you'd send that convicting fire down. Lord, that today, tonight, would be their night of salvation. Lord, whether if somebody was to come in, Lord, with chains of bondage, Lord, I pray them chains to be broke and lives to be changed. And I ask all these things in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
As I was thinking upon that and pondering on that, I thought about where it said, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that your bodies is a living sacrifice. Acceptable, we're holy, we're supposed to be holy. If we've been saved and born again, that we're acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service.
Amen.
That's our service as children of God to be acceptable and holy unto Him. And I ask y'all to pray tonight. Sometimes it's hard as preaching, it's hard because sometimes you get burdened down for the churches, and that's the way that I feel tonight. Brother Jackson and Brother Andrew, y'all know what I'm talking about. You get burdened for the churches, you get burdened for the lost, and sometimes it gets heavy on your shoulders, and you think, Lord, how much more can I bear? But that's when that light shines through. Sometimes as preaching, and singers know it, and people, it's hard sometimes. You go here and there, and you're in different churches, and sometimes it's hard to get free at different places because people is so bound up. So many people's defeated. So many people don't know what to do. And you know, all you can say, as I told them this morning, I preached a sermon here a while back. I think it was here that I told them. I don't know if y'all remember 1 Peter 5:7, casting all your care upon him for he cares for you. And I told them at that church over there this morning, I said, if you just cast all your care upon him and you tell somebody every day what Jesus has done for you and just tell them that Jesus loves them, that'll be enough. And they may go do one of two things. They'll either walk away or they won't have, or they will respond to that. And you know, my prayer was this afternoon as I was pondering upon this word, I said, Lord, whatever you'd have me to do, and I come this way tonight to get free, and I hope you did too. And I just, when you're preaching, there's a press to it. And you know, a lot of people, I know, I seem old-fashioned to some, but I've never got a hold of the power of the Lord but by prayer and fasting. And you know, I'm thankful tonight for the word the Lord put on me, but we've got a lot of churches today that they're tossed to and fro, and a lot of churches today don't know what to do. And you know, you see people in today's time that'll say, well, brother, we're so defeated. The church is getting in bad shape. This church, or I'm not talking about just one church in general. I'm talking about every church in the countryside. And I want y'all to just open your heart tonight, because I come to preach and come to get free. And I'm thankful tonight for the Word of God. And people in today's time, they wonder a lot of times on what they're going to do. And as you sit back and watch their lives, not to be a judge, but the Bible says that we can't examine. And you know, as you sit back and watch people's lives and you watch how they live, and people in today's time, they'll say, I can't do this or I can't do that, and churches is defeated. And you look back and you sit back, y'all just bear with me, I'm going somewhere with this message. And you look back on their lives and they're not living by the Word of God, they're not living by the things of God. And then you see them again later on and they say the same old thing. And you just got to say, well, have you been praying? A lot of people ain't been praying. And then people that's walking defeated, they forgot the ways of God, and they forgot how to what the Bible actually says about things. And the Bible says that our bodies is a living sacrifice. Every one of us in our everyday lives, we're a living sacrifice. Everybody, we're holy and we're acceptable unto God. And I was thinking and pondering upon that if we had everybody in our churches today that would read on that verse and on that scripture that I read, that people, a lot of things in today's churches would be different. When you come in, people, you wouldn't have to worry about, well, is people going to move? Is people going to reach out and as I say, touch the Lord and grab a hold of that Holy Ghost? You wouldn't have to ask that anymore. Preachers just about have to get a dog leash on people just to get them to move. And that's a shame. And you know, people can say, well, it's the preacher's fault. Sometimes it can be. But if the church ain't moving and the preacher's got the power, that's where it's the church's fault. Because if the preachers want, if the preachers is preaching the Word of God and people, if the preachers is preaching the Word of God and people ain't accepting that, then that's on them. You lost people to get saved and people to get changed and changed to be broken. That's when it comes by the church. People, preachers can't save you and preacher can't reach that. It comes by the church. Preachers in today's time, and I'm a member here, but you go in different places, of course, ain't a member there, but me preaching to them, I'm part of them. Everybody, as you come in, whether you're members or not, the membership don't mean nothing, but as you're a part of the members and you're all in one body, that's Jesus Christ. You can go to this church this Sunday and this church next Sunday. If they believe in the Bible from the very front to the very back, then you're all part of that church. Blood bought. And we need people in today's time that's going to stand upon that. And I'm thankful as I was pondering on that, and thoughts come to my mind just as fast as I was reading it. And I said, Lord, I said, thank you for that word, because more people need to really read that and study upon that, because we've got a lot of people in workplaces and in their everyday lives, and they don't know who they are. lot of people don't even know what they are. And people, when they claim to be saved, and they may be, I don't know. But people, as they go around and they say they're saved, and as I was saying, they say they're defeated. But if people would hold the mighty hand of God, I read this morning, I cling to the mighty hand of God. I'm putting that in my own words, but I can find it for you where it says that. And I think a lot of times that if people will hold to His hand, and as they're walking through their daily lives, imagine how many people that we could touch. Imagine how many people. I was telling Taylor the other day as we was going down the road, I wished it. If many people just knew how short of time that we had left, I guarantee you that people would be doing a lot of things different. People would be acting different. People would be talking different. And people would be, they'd be opening their Bibles. And it's probably a good thing. I know that we don't know when the Lord's coming back. But I can tell you, if we knew just how short of time that we had left, I know what I would be doing. And I'm including me in that. Sometimes we all get lazy on the Lord. How many people can say they get lazy on the Lord? A lot of us do. Every one of us do. But if we just told somebody about the Lord, if we knew how short of time that we had left, I'll tell you what I'd be doing. I'd be going up on the square in town and preaching the Word of God and telling people that Jesus is coming back. I'd be going door to door and telling people that Jesus loves them. I'd be telling them that Jesus loves them, and to tell them how short of time that they had left. And I'd be telling the drug addicts how short of time that we had, and tell them that Jesus loves them. And you know, a lot of times you can't speak religion at your workplace. I know I can't, but if you live right and you do right, you don't have to say nothing. People know what you believe in by how you walk and how you talk. And you know, you can say, well, brother, I don't believe that you've got to quote scripture. I said to a man one time, he said he don't know just what words to say to people. And I said, you don't have to have no big words to say to people when you're witnessing to them. Just tell them what the Lord's done for you, and that's all you'll need. Yes, scripture, and just tell them what the Lord's done for you. And if the Lord's really done that for you, it'll back it up right here in the Word. Just tell them what He's done for you. You can say, well, brother, the Lord just ain't done much for me. Yes, He has. Has He saved your soul? Yes, He has. That's enough right there. And I thank you for Sunday night. We was talking at the radio this morning one Sunday night. The Lord heard a sinner's prayer. I'm changing that up. But the Lord heard a sinner's prayer. And it wasn't nothing that somebody told me to say, but it was a sinner's prayer right down from the bottom of my heart. It wasn't nothing that I had to look at the older generation to ask what to say. It was something I knew. And you know, if as you're witnessing to people in your everyday lives, and a lost person, you know, you ask them if they've ever been saved, and if they say no, what are you going to do if they say, how do I get saved? What do you say then? You just tell them. You start by telling them Jesus Christ loves them, and begin telling them. I tell people on the altar many times in seeking salvation, you tell the Lord what you want. You tell the Lord what you're in need of, and He's just to forgive you. And that, you know, I'm thankful tonight that as I was reading upon the Word in our recliners, I was looking under the TV. We've got that Bible verse, Joshua 24:15, and as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord. And as I was thinking upon that, I thought a lot of people in our churches today, they have quotes and Bible verses in their homes, and they have them on the wall, but they have them for decorations. A lot of people's not living it. A lot of people go to a lot of stores, you can't get Bible verses like that anymore, but you have to go to certain one, and people will get them just because they look good. They'll help with the decoration in their home. You know, I was thinking upon that, and I thought if people, Jackson, would just live upon that Bible verse, as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord. We need people in today's time that's not just going to put Bible verses on the walls and Bible verses on their vehicles and this, that, and other, and on their desk at work and stuff. We need people that's going to live right, and people that's going to live by that. And you know, I'll just go ahead and read that to you. I like to like to not just people take my word, but you can't say I'm wrong if I read it to you. Joshua 24:15, and it says, "And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, said, choose you this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your father served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord." And you know, people need to read that. People need to study upon that. I'm not talking about to serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord on Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday. I'm talking about as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord Monday through Sunday. 7 days a week, 24 hours. You know, a lot of people, as I was pondering upon that too, I was thinking, and me and the Lord was talking, and how many people in your everyday lives had visitations for the Lord, from the Lord every now and then. I know I do, and I'm thankful for those times that I had visitations from the Lord. And as I was pondering on that, I thought about people, how they'll let their kids do it. I'm not preaching going in your home, but I believe in preaching the Bible, and this is the Bible right here. But if you're letting your kids go places where things is going on, and you're letting and you're going places that things is going on that's not fitting, that's not going on by the Bible,
Amen.
You better watch out, because that's sin.
Amen.
And you're going places, and you're getting conversations with people out at the gas station, grocery stores, wherever you're at, and they start to say things or do things that's not acceptable unto God, you better be walking away. Because there'll come a time when you're going to have to pay for that. There'll be a time down here, I truly believe, that you'll reap what you sow. The Bible says that, and there'll be a time when you'll stand before the Lord on that judgment one day. And you say, "Brother, what's this have to do with the Word?" If you just pay attention to what I'm preaching, and you go back and read that tonight, when you get home, or you read it right now, let me tell you, you'll understand where I'm coming from. You'll understand that we're supposed to be holy unto God, and you can say, "Well, that's just doing this, that, and other when you want to." No, a lot of our churches today is getting in a shape that they're going by the motions. We see a lot when we go different places, and I thank God that we get to go to them places to minister and plant a seed and sow something and be a help to those people. But a lot of places you go and people is just people's going by the motions. People just going and just going to church just to say they've been to church. I remember a time even when I was just a little boy when you went to church, and when you got out you could say you've been to church. I'm not just talking about just saying that you went to church, but you could say you actually been to church. You can say, "Well, brother, what do you mean?" Well, if we have church at our home and the Lord passes by and something breaks loose, I can say, "I've been to church." Not just at Grace Union or somewhere else, but if we have a visitation from the Lord at home, I can say I've been to church. And I'm thankful that for those times that I can say that I've been to church. And until you get humble under the sight of God and to the mighty hand of God, as I read this morning over there in 1 Peter, I read over there, and I was talking about that, and I told those people, I said, "If we'll hold to the mighty hand of God and we'll really humble ourselves down, we'll see things change in our churches. We're getting in a bad shape." And I tell you, my biggest concern in today's time is, I know within my heart that we don't have very long to stay here, but my biggest concern is these little ones that's growing up, and they're growing up in a world that tells them that wrong is right and right is wrong.
Right.
And what are we going to do, church, when that time comes when we send our kids to school and they tell them that? You say, "Brother, that's not coming." Yes, it is. It truly is. And we're in hard times now, but we've not saw nothing yet that's coming. We're saying there's rough days that's coming, and we're going to have to put on the whole armor of God. And if we're not ready for those times, you know what's going to happen. We're not going to be strong enough, and the world's just going to knock us down. And those times is really coming to us. And, you know, I think a lot of times there's times coming in workplaces all across the land when they're going to say, if you even speak the name of God, you're not going to have a place of employment. That time's coming. There's already a time coming. Nothing against people that got that vaccine. Nothing against it. that you prayed against. If you prayed for that and you didn't feel nothing, that's up to you. Nothing against people that got it, but a time's coming when people say if you don't have a vaccine, you can't enter. That time's coming. I truly believe it. And then I believe there's a time coming when you can't pray but at your homes. And if you get caught praying at your homes, you're going to be put in jail. People say, brother, I don't believe in putting a dark cloud over the church. I don't either, but it's the truth. That's why churches is in the shape that we're in. It's because we've got preachers not bold enough to stand on that. And preachers that's not bold enough to preach that. And you say, well, brother, what do you do if somebody tells you you can't do it? Preach it anyway. If they don't like it, they'll never call you back. And if your workplace don't like it, you'll find somewhere else. That's the way I see it. That's the times that we're getting. I think a lot of times as I'm going about daily lives at work or out at the gas station or something, I think a lot of times, I think, Lord, I hope when people see me, they see you and nothing more, nothing less. And that's what I hope because we need people in our daily lives that they can say when your name's mentioned, they can say that person has really got the Lord with them. If I needed something, that person's somebody I could go to that would tell me the honest truth based upon the Word. And we need people. That's why it's important to know the Word of God. I don't know it like I should, but my prayer is, Lord, just open my heart every time that I study. Because it's important. A time's coming when people, as the Bible says, and I can find it in there, says a time's coming when people have itching ears. And they'll go to places that the preachers will preach what they want them to preach. I heard a guy one time, he went to a church's different denomination, but it's still the Bible. He said they put in on a bowl the back of the doors that the preacher, you tell the preacher what you'd like him to preach. Let me tell you, if that happens somewhere you're going and that happens, you better get out of there. Because that ain't nothing but the devil. You better get out of there. Preacher asks you what you want him to preach. You better get out of there. We need people today that's going to preach the Word of God and is going to preach the truth. And stand upon it. And we need people today that's going to stand and is going to say, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. That comes with Grace Union Church too. As for me and this church, we're going to serve the Lord. That time's coming. As for me and our house, our church, we're going to serve the Lord. And people come. They come, if they go, they go. The Lord's going to supply every need. He said He'd supply every need that we have. And He said, I truly believe also a time's coming when people, it's going to be hard for them to get saved. That time's already coming. You say, well, brother, how's that already coming? It's coming right here. Because there's a time where people don't even want to have an invitation. People don't even want to worship the Lord. In our churches today, I'm very concerned. Our churches today, I'm talking about every church in this world, I'm very concerned. If we don't start standing upon the Word of God, there's going to come a time when we don't have a church to go to. There's going to come a time when we'll be locked on the doors and we can't go and we'll say, I wish I had done more. I wish I would have just held on and just stood firm. If people went, they went. If they didn't, they didn't. The stuff that we take for granted, and I'll tell you, Grace Union, don't take for granted what you have here, because let me tell you, there's many places, and soon be 2 years that I've been preaching, going different places. There's a lot of places that's just as cold as ice. A lot of places, if somebody was to really preach the Word, if somebody was to really take off a shout or something, it would scare them to death. And that, you look at it, it's kind of, you know, people want to laugh at that, but that's the truth. That's how sad that it is in today's time. We've got people that'll hold to them pews instead of move. We got people that'll hold to the pews instead of doing what the Lord wants them to do. Whatever the Lord wants you to do, it's time that we do. Every one of us has got somebody that we can reach out to. Every single one of us in our lives has got somebody that we can witness to. Imagine, I've said it before, imagine if we all just won one soul a year to Jesus Christ. Imagine how many people that would be. How many people that would be. And I'm telling you, our churches is getting in a mess, and people better be praying. People better be staying concerned, and it's time that people, another thought that come to me when I was studying on that, is people better forget the things of the world and start coming in and worshiping the Lord in one mind and one accord. It's time to beat them. Don't worry about this and don't worry about that and start serving the Lord. Because if we don't quit worrying about the things of the world when we come into the church house, then let me tell you, there'll be a time when we'll be dead. There'll be a time before you know it that the devil will be all over this place. And I'm not just saying this at Grace Union, I'd say it anywhere I go. If you don't start praying and you don't start forgetting the things of the world, then let me tell you, there'll be a time come when you're dead. That's just, and that goes with me. If I don't come praying and come with a message every time somebody calls me to preach, then there'll be a time when people don't call me to preach at their church, and I can't blame them. If people call me to preach at their church and I was dead and didn't have nothing and just fumbled through the Bible and was just dead and stuff, you know, I couldn't blame them for never calling me back. If I didn't bring them the Word of God and the way the Lord called me, I wouldn't want to call me back either. And that's just people need to really think, what do you want to do? What do you want to do in your life? Do you want to keep going with the motions like a lot of churches is doing today and have a format about going through things and do what you want to do? Or are you going to serve the Lord? Are you going to say, yes, for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord? When the time comes, persecution's coming for God's people. Persecution's coming, and I believe it with all my heart. Persecution is a thing that a scary situation in the eyes of Christians. But let me tell you, if you've got Jesus Christ, you've got everything that you'll ever need. You've got the whole armor of God. You've got everything that you'll ever need. And if people will humble themselves down to the mighty hand of God, like I said, you find that in 1 Peter. Humble yourselves in the mighty hand of God. Let me tell you, a time's coming, as I was saying, when Christians are... they won't be able to worship the Lord, won't even be able to speak the name of Jesus everywhere you go. And there's going to be a time that it's either going to be speak the name of Jesus or lose your job. What are you going to do? That's when faith steps in. We talked about that this morning. That's when faith steps in. And I would hope that there's people here today, under the sound of my voice, that would say, I'm going to stand for God. If all hell comes toward me, I'm still going to stand for God. If everything, if somebody tells me I can't speak the name of Jesus, I'm going to speak it anyway. A lot of people anymore, when they you hear something that you can't do something, they do it anyway. We're not talking about it. You've got to leap from the Lord to say something about Him. And you, if somebody tells you you can't, you better do it anyway. And people can say, and that's not to be just for show. That's to plant a seed. Everywhere you go, if you're going somewhere and it's hard, your family is the hardest for me anyways. I'd say it's hard for you. Your family is the hardest to witness to. That just about everybody can say that. And you know, even when you're around your family, I struggle with that. About standing firm upon what you believe in. Standing firm upon God's Word. And I said something to somebody here a couple weeks ago. I said, if what you believe, you can back it up by the Bible, you'll never go wrong.
That's right.
And you know, if you're in the flesh and you can't back it up by the Bible, that's when you'll go wrong. And that's when, before you know it, you're going to have to pay for that because you didn't back it up by the Bible. But it's time that we start backing things up by the Bible and get to that place to know that we're holy and acceptable unto God. We're living sacrifice for Him. Are we or are we not? The question is, church, I leave a question for everybody. What are we going to do? Are we going to keep sitting? Are we going to keep sitting? Or are we going to just wander around? Or are we going to stand for God? When we come in the church house, and I say this a lot of places, when we go into church houses, are we just going to sit down and go through the motions and go home just so we can say that we've been to church? Or are we going to stand for God? Are we going to stand for God? From now on, you ought to make yourself a deal. From now on, until the Lord comes back, you ought to say, I'm going to stand for God. Even if all hell comes toward me, I'm going to stand for God. When people pull up on your driveway of your home, they ought to be able to know this house serves the Lord. Yeah. This house serves the Lord, and people pull up on this parking lot. I've heard a lot of people say it, and thank God for that. If they say they can feel the Spirit of the Lord when they pull up on this parking lot, the same should be when people pull in your driveway. They can say this house They stand for something. I see when you see people out, and I see them sometimes how they act and stuff. I can say, "Have you been saved and born again?" I say, "How do you know?" I say, "One, you. I can tell by how you live." And that ought—that's the way it ought to be with everybody. People ought to be able to tell how you live. And people, if you've got a question about anything, it's good to go to a preacher that you have trust in. But I ask you to go by the Word of God. Don't go by what no man says. You may have confidence in me. Hope that you do. Pretty sure that you do. But if you've got a question before you come to me, you open your Bible before you ask somebody. And you say, "Well, I trust you. I'm glad that you do. And I can," and you can come to me and we'll open up the Bible and see what the Bible says about it. And then we can study on it. But people in churches today is letting everything come in. I'm almost done, but y'all just bear with me. People in churches today is letting everything come in, and people's not standing. We need men that's going to stand. We need women that's going to stand. No matter what, if it's based up upon the Bible, we need people that's going to stand for God. We need people that's not going to go by man's word, but they're going to go by God's word. That's why our churches has gotten the shape that they're in. People's not going by the word of God. I'm thankful this tonight that I know by what I believe in, it goes by the Bible. I'm not bragging on me, but you ask me something I believe in, I may not be able to quote you a book, chapter, and verse, but you give me about an hour and I can find it. And you know what? I'm thankful tonight for the Word of God. Another question, what are you thankful for? It's time to start getting thankful, have thankful hearts. Everywhere we go, sometimes, as I said earlier, sometimes it's hard. You get weary and you get down, and sometimes the struggle of life and everyday life sometimes gets you down. You get so busy in life and you don't know exactly what to do. But that's when we ought to be plugged up. We ought to still be able to have a smile on our face. I said last week at Winfrey's Chapel, that's a gift that every one of us have, is a smile. Every one of us has got something to offer. If that's all you've got to offer, and that's honorable. God pleases. He's pleasing to that. And I'm thankful tonight. I pray that every one of you opened your heart to the Word of God, what I preached. And I know it may not seem like much, but that's all right. I just want you to apply that to your life. And I'm not just talking about you applying it to your life, but I've got to apply it to mine also. Because in order for me to preach to you, I've got to live. A lot of preachers today, I'm thankful we've got preachers around Grace Union that I can truly say lives what they preach. But we've got a lot of preachers today that's not living what they preach. And there'll be a day of judgment coming for them people. And you know, you say, "Well, brother, you ought not say the truth like that." Well, a lot of people understand the truth better than you do sugarcoat it, so I just choose to speak the truth. But we've got a lot of even church people that don't even believe the Bible don't even back up what they believe in.
That's right.
Got a lot of people, and you look at their church congregation and how their church is, and you know what it is? It's dead. It's dead, and then they look and they ask, "Well, what can I do?" Start believing the Bible and start living the Bible. And you'll see changes in the people in the church. You'll see changes in your preaching. And you know, a lot of people, I know, a lot of people say that I walk a lot, but I can't sit still. And everybody knows that. But that's the way the Lord anointed me when He called me to preach. But you know, a lot of people get distracted upon things that in the churches. But if people will come in with an open heart, open mind, and willing to serve the Lord, in spirit and in truth, as I said, it don't matter what color, what race, no matter what you are, you come in and visit a church, you're one. Whether the church people want to admit or not, we're all one. It don't matter who you are. And you know it's time that we start praying for the drunkards, the drug addicts, the homosexuals. Amen. A lot of people forgot about them people.
Yeah.
We don't need to forget about them people.
Right.
They've got a soul just like we do.
Right.
And they've got a soul that's in need of salvation. Right. And they got a soul that's headed toward a place called hell one day.
Right.
And you know, I'm guilty of it too as I go in my daily lives and how many of them people that I pass by in my everyday life. And I don't say nothing about that. Shame on me. But one of these days, I don't want to have to stand before the Lord and say, "Lord, I wished I'd have done more. Wished I'd have done more." And you know the truth of God's word is there's going to be more that's going to find hell to be their home than people that's going to find heaven to be their home. You can say, why is that? I believe with all of my heart that it's because they didn't, one, they didn't want to, and two, that they didn't have enough, that there wasn't enough preachers to tell them the good news, wasn't enough preachers to tell you the gospel truth. A lot of people's leaving the blood out of the churches. And let me tell you, as long as time stands, the blood's still there.
Amen.
It applies to my soul, and any soul that's saved today, it still applies to them.
Amen.
And it'll apply for everyone. Follow your heart tonight. You've got a, this altar is open. Anytime I'm preaching, it's an AC at this church. This altar is always open. You've got a need, a burden, whatever it is, you can take it to the Lord. But make sure you leave it there. A lot of people, they got a burden and things that they want to see done. They come up to the altar and they'll pray about it and then they'll pick it back up and take it back home with them. It's time that we start really getting down to business. It's time we get to the Father's business. Because let me tell you, time's coming when we'll wish that we had what we have now. Times are getting harder and harder. We're living in hard times now, but we've not saw nothing yet. We've not saw nothing yet. But when you come up this altar, just make sure you leave it there. Don't pick it back up. I'm guilty of it.